to record some new features of the PIVX wallet on the testnet, showing some of the most recent added features of Zerocoin related stuff. Okay, so this should look same as before. We're going to now look at the privacy tab. And I'm not sure how much this has changed here on the right, maybe the same. I think the numbers here may have been added to add more clarification. So you'll notice a couple things here that are different. One is the minimize change option. So what this does is, if let's say you were to, you wanted to pay, say 23 zPiv, then without this enabled, what would happen is that if you want to pay 23, it would basically look at the next higher denomination that you have, which would be a 50. And so it would do one spend of a 50, and you'd end up getting back 27 PIV or 26 zPIV in change, provided that you couldn't exactly... if you didn't exactly have the change or the available denominations to meet 23 exactly. So in our case here, we have two 10s and three 1s, so we would be able to do it. But if you didn't have any 1s, you basically would not be able to do it, meet it exactly. And so it would use a 50 and give you back the change, as I mentioned. However, with the minimized change option, what it'll do is, rather than going to the next higher denomination, in that case, it would actually use two 10s and a 5. So you would end up with two PIV, or one zPIV as change and one PIV as a fee. So in that case, as you can see, the amount of change you get is being minimized at the expense of using more spends, more spent coins. And in terms of individual coins. So it's kind of, the first method is simpler because you just pick a higher one, but you may end up with a lot of change. So this one just minimizes the amount of change you get. So in terms of fees or anything, it won't really be that much different. It should be the same, but it's a question of whether you want a lot of change to use in the future, or you just want to get as little change as possible. I'm going to just demo, I'll spend this first time. After it comes back, the number of denoms with 1 should go to 0, and then if we do it again, you should see the difference. So in this case, it should be able to meet it exactly. There shouldn't be any difference here. Okay, this is calculating. And okay, sent. So if you look through the info here, you can see, you know, that it basically used two 10s and three 1s as expected. So now if we just send someone else to a different wallet here, and let's try the 23 again. Now we'll see what happens. There we go. And as you can see from the window here, two 10s and a 5. And let's try it one more time now, this time without the minimized change. Now this time it should just use a 50. In all these cases, I didn't convert my change to Zerocoin, so you do get your change back as PIV, which, again, as we said, for privacy, may be better to use zPIV. So in this case, you can see it just used one spent of one denomination of 50, and you get 27 in change. And you can see it's a little faster too, because the spending does take a little more time to calculate the equations and stuff. So it's a little faster. Okay, so then another option we have that's new is zPIV control. So this is similar to coin control, but what you can actually do is you can pick the coins you want to use. So, and the window here, if we expand it, There's an ID associated with each coin. There's a number of confirmations. You can see they're all really big. That's because I haven't minted any in quite a while. And it tells you whether they're spendable or not. And it may not be because it may not be mature yet on the network. So there's a couple of options here. You know, you're better using older coins if possible. So let's just pick a couple of coins. So I get 500 and a 10. And then we hit OK. And so let's spend 508. And so that should use the 510 we picked, and it should have change of 2. I'm going to convert to Zerocoin back. So we should basically get 1 Zerocoin minted back. So, okay, let's try this one. And hopefully in this case, if you should be able to check also that it did use the ones you selected. I'm not sure how to do that at the moment, yeah, we'll look into how to check that, I guess, in the future. But you can see that, you know, if you wanted, you know, if you wanted to spend, let's say, 5 PIV and you want to use 5 ones rather than a 5, then that should be possible. So here you see it picked a 500 and a 10, as we said, and we got 1 PIV in change and 1 PIV SV.